submitted yet. Specifically, the first objective, I think we need a little bit more work with, and that's what your entry task is going to be asking you to think about. So even if you're not done with your objectives yet, I'd like you to go ahead and pause, and I want you to take a look at the turn and talk question in the entry task. So you've seen this equation before, yes?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, I'd like you to think about the atoms in that reaction. What specifically is happening to those atoms? And think about like what you did with the model kits and all of that kind of stuff. And I'd like you to turn and talk with your partner about it. And I'd like even partners to go first. And then I'm going to call in a couple of odd partners. There we go. I'm going to call in a couple of odd partners to share out. And then if needed, depending on how we build up our answer to this, then we might have a second turn and talk question. So let's go ahead and do your turn and talk now, and then you can finish with your objectives a little bit later.
The molecule H2O is the thing to happen is that the atoms of the same kind, you just add the number and becoming another kind of molecule. For example,
I have the water, makes water.
Three different kind of atoms in this
particle.
You have hydrogen, oxygen, and carbon. This means that the oxygen is becoming the oxygen and form a new bond. That means that, for example, if you have H2O becoming plus CO2, that's becoming in H2CO3. That means that the atoms of the same type just add to the other, and the different kind just you have to add to the molecule.
I agree.
I'm getting science.
Because the atoms broke up, creating a bond, and became it's two silicates.
And then there is something new I want to try out today. So you guys have been doing the turn and talks, even partner first, and odd partner says what you heard him say, and agree and add on, or disagree and add on. I'd like to think about now when we do share outs, how we respond to each other in share outs. Because you guys are really good about responding to each other in the individual, like the little partner work. But I want to make sure that we're actually listening to everything that's happening in the share out as well. And so what I'd like you to think about is I'm going to have one group share first, and I want you to be thinking about what you can add on to their idea, just like what you do with your partner. So based on what you and your table partner talked about, what can you either agree and add on to the person who shared before you, or somebody who shared two people before you, or whatever, or how can you disagree with their idea respectfully and add on your thinking? So I've got a couple sentences up there. You're welcome to say it in another way, but I want you to think about what did you hear the person before you say, and how can you build on it to make sure to share what you heard them say, and then how you're going to build on it. I'd like everybody to read the two quoted sentence stems up there. We have the same ideas as, and then whoever shared their idea, when they said, and what they said. And we also said, so this is where you're adding on. So adding on reasoning to what they said. Or we thought blank instead of, and then whatever somebody else said, because that sentence sounds a little bit wrong. I should say instead of blank. And so do I have a volunteer odd partner that would like to go first? So we can have something to build on? Chris? Okay, so, and by atoms, or, sorry, so the atoms are bonded? Yeah. Okay, atoms are bonded, you agree, and so what? led me to think about what you and your partner said. And would you agree with this in ad hoc? Or would you say what you thought differently and add on something new to it? So use one of those two sentence stems out there. So did you have the same ideas as Chris and Cressida when they said this?
We had the same ideas as
Chris and
Cressida. But we also said that they formed a new model.
We have the same idea as Jack and Esteban.
Okay. And they said
what? They said they form a new molecule, H2CO3, because, and we also said that the when they come together, they break apart and create new bonds. That's how they make up an emotion.
Okay. So you said similar but in a different way. So you said when they come together, they break up. And the they here is that, do you mean the atoms, the bonds, the molecules, what's breaking up?
Yeah, bond.
You said bond?
But.
Both what?
Both molecule and the bond, because for creative space for the new atoms that is going to be in the molecule, they have to, for example, in the CO2, they have double bonds in each atom. That means that they have to separate one bond of each atom to that the other atom of O, that is oxygen of the H2O, had to combine it, and this means that they had to create a new space.
Somebody like to volunteer?
also shared ideas with Chris and Cressida, where the atoms are bonded because they collide with each other. And we also said that the atoms from each molecule, they kind of break certain bonds and latch onto each other.
Okay, and does that idea build on a previous one, or are you agreeing with it, something else?
I think we're building on with the colliding.
Okay. And so can you say it one more time, like you're adding on?
That because when the bonds are broken, the atoms like latch onto certain other ones with the open bonds. What's that one?
Bonds.
Potential bonds.